Sean, the state says they have evidence that Linscott and Dow tried to coach the child about what to say to a state worker who was there to check on the welfare of that child.
Written communication would be all right with the court, but only if it's monitored through the child's therapist and only his therapist.
With that, Judge Marguerite Wagling gave Jessica Linscott some of what she was seeking. The defense wanted Linscott to be able to have contact with her son. The defense saying that Linscott is a far different person than the one that was arrested last year.
She is not the same person that she was when she was in that relationship. She is focusing on herself and doing what she needs to do with DCYF to try and work on having a relationship with her son.
Linscott is charged for failing to get medical attention for her son after he was allegedly bruised and beaten by her boyfriend, Roland Dow. The two dropped off the three-year-old at a hospital last November and then fled. Eventually, they were arrested in Florida. The state objected to Linscott having any contact, saying they have evidence that she and Dow engaged in witness tampering with the child, who could be called as a witness.
And the concern the state has was there's a prior recorded incident of them attempting to influence what JN said during an official visit. So that's the concern we have.
Currently, Dow is scheduled to go on trial in April, Linscott in June, but with these new charges forthcoming, well, both trials could be delayed. As for the child, James, according to both sides, he is doing well. Reporting live in Brentwood, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.